If I compare these two, I would say that every city is visited at least once. Sounds like each clause must be satisfied. So we must basically ensure that our satisfying assignment satisfies it at least once. So I think this one here is closely related to this one down here. The main decision is the order in which to visit the cities. That is what makes this problem hard. And the analogous decision that you have to make for sat is deciding which variables to set to true or to false. So I think these two here are quite closely related. Then being able to visit a city more than once, but not having to do so, I think that is closely related to number four, because what we have here is one variable is enough to satisfy a clause. But of course, we can use more than one variable to satisfy the clause. It doesn't hurt if there's more variables here that will evaluate to true. So we can satisfy a clause in multiple ways, but we don't have to. One single variable is enough. And then finally, saying that each variable is either true or false, I think, and this is probably the hardest one to figure out, that that is actually quite closely related to saying that you don't visit a city more than once on purpose. It means you basically have to make a decision what city to visit next. And that is, in my mind, more or less close to saying I'm setting a variable to either true or false. Once you go along the shortest tour, you're always on your way to a new city. But again, I realize this might be a bit subjective here. Let's use this relationship to try and reduce sat to shortest tour. And I think we should start out with this relation here. Deciding true or false is what makes sat hard. The main decision is the order in which to visit the cities. So the important insight here is that we should try and find some way to represent true or false as an order in which cities are visited, and to assure through that order also that you cannot have an ambiguous assignment of true or false. So basically, you have to make a decision in which order you visit the cities, and that must represent either true or false. And to figure this out, of course, that takes a lot of playing around with different networks. So even though I had learned the proof, I didn't quite remember how to do it. And it took me 15 or 20 minutes to play around on a piece of paper with a pen to find out how I could represent true or false variables as an order in which cities are visited. And there's many possibilities, but I'll show you what I came up with and then explain that to you.